What's good, y'all? It's your boy Jay the Way here again. Now, I want to talk today about social media narcissists and seeking validation from social media. I felt like this is an important topic to make because we are so engulfed in this generation, starting from 2012 in social media. If you have done any of these things that I'm about to say, then you obsessively care about social media too much. And you seek too much validation from social media. Have you ever frustratingly took a photo over and over again because you wanted to look perfect for Instagram? And then once you got that perfect photo, have you sat down for 5 minutes after you posted it, scrolling to see who liked it? And then you waited another 10 minutes to see who liked it and not as many people liked it as you thought. And then now you're sitting for 30 minutes and now you think not enough people like your post, so you decide to delete it. Did you decide not to post something because you didn't think it was going to get likes? Or did you ever post something and it got more likes than you thought and you felt good about it? Do you ever unfollow someone because that person didn't follow you back and you didn't follow that person because you truly wanted to see that person's content, but you're just trying to get some clout on social media? Do you ever feel butthurt about who doesn't follow you back? If you've done any of these things before, I hate to say it, my friend, you care about social media way too much and you need to change your mindset. Sit down and ask yourself why these things make you feel this way. Does it make you feel special? Does it make you feel validated? Does it make you feel more popular or more like an important person? Does a lack of likes or followers make you feel embarrassed? Unpopular, like you the scum of the earth and you shitty? This is a self-improvement channel and we here are trying to be the best versions of ourselves. No one who is the best version of themselves could possibly care about what other people think about them through social media, and even worse, people who don't even give a shit about you. Most of your followers don't even truly care about you. You can't be the best version of yourself if you care about this type of crap this much. High value men or high value people who are too busy working on themselves, running their business, making six figures a year, or got things going on in their life, they have purpose, they have hobbies, could not possibly care about social media this much. These are the type of people who try to put a fake image, like they're living a life that they're not, on social media so they can look better. Fake people insist their lives are perfect and they have to try to prove it to people through things when their life is not nearly as perfect as it is. You post perfect pictures of yourself, heavily edited, and you sit down thinking about what caption you want to write because you are trying to insist that your life is perfect or happy when you deep down know that your life is not. When I was camping just a few days ago, there was a girl in the mountains. She was trying so hard to get the perfect Instagram photo and she kept looking at us, trying to see that if we were looking at her or staring at her or judging at her because she knows that she looks stupid. And what she's trying to do is she keeps trying to jump up and down to get this perfect photo of her in the air. I could see in the rear view mirror that she's trying to act stupid just to get this perfect photo to post on Instagram. It's so sad how far people are willing to go to make themselves look good on social media. I have more perfect examples of this, and I'm not trying to claim that I know that these people were trying to live perfect lives, but what I'm trying to say is social media is never representative of what is in real life. Have you seen the Chris Watts case? Shannon Watts, his wife, before he brutally murdered her and their two daughters, she posted on social media all the time about how their life was going so great and their life through social media looked perfect, but social media never showed you that Chris Watts was a psychopath and ended up murdering his own family. In the book iGen, there's a study that clearly shows when social media started taking off in 2012, this coincided with teens hanging out less than they usually did. Because on social media, those people don't, like I've said over and over again, don't care about you. Real connections are not made. through social media, through someone liking your post and commenting on your post. There are some sorority girls that I know at LSU that I'm good friends with. They have like 10,000 followers, you know, and their lives look perfect on their photos. But you know what they've told me? I'm not saying this. They told me this. They told me that after they graduated from college, they don't talk to anybody from LSU. Yet half or pretty much all their 10,000 followers are people from LSU. Do you really think their social media followers is a sign that they're actually friends with these people? Ever since 2012, we are in the worst mental health crisis ever since then. Ever since cell phones and social media started coming out, the rate of suicide and depression has skyrocketed ever since then. On a Wall Street Journal investigation of Facebook, they discovered that 32% of women who go on Instagram who already felt bad about their physical body said that Instagram made it worse. And let me tell you something, on Instagram, there's such thing as angles and photo editing. People don't look like that all the time. Another study by York University showed that there were 12 women that were conducted in a study. And when they were shown pictures of women that were, they thought that they were more attractive than them, they all said that they felt worse about themselves afterwards. And lastly, there was another study conducted in UPenn where the people told a group of sample of people to only look at their social media for at max 10 minutes a day. And after the length of the study was conducted, these people all said that they felt better about themselves, they felt less anxiety, and they felt less FOMO, which is the fear of missing out. Guys, I can go on and on about this, but if you are not convinced at this point that social media is doing a lot of harm to people, you are lost. And be humble about this because this might be affecting you and you might not even be realizing it yourself. If you were to go on social media, make sure that you're using it in a way to be the best version of yourself. So people use social media to promote their business or to, you know, if you're trying to promote your own YouTube channel, people make their page for that. You know, and people also post things that they like and they don't worry about the likes. If you're using social media in a healthy way, that's good for you. But I know that a lot of people out there, these hypocrites, say that they don't care about social media likes or followers, but deep down they really do. But guys, that ends it for this video. Remember to leave this video a like, comment down below what you want to see next, and I'll see you in the next video. Jay the Way Out.